Hello, welcome back to the second part lesson where we want to look at some of the factors that hasten economic development. What fastens the level of economic development? One, we look at improved infrastructure and social amenities. Now, when we have better roads, we have good roads, we have modern communication, right? We have hospitals, we have schools, we have stadiums, social halls. This is going to bring about faster economic development. Number two, industrialization, right? When industries now we have a developed system of government. So when we have industries in every county, they're going to employ people. They're going to have raw materials in the community. This brings about faster economic development. Improving research and development. Now we have COVID-19. There's a lot of research coming up with a vaccine. Research costs money. When you research, you come up with new and better methods of production. That will bring about development. Education and training. People are educated. People are trained on better methods of production. That is going to produce, to bring about faster economic development. Use of modern technology production. When we embrace modern technology production, which are more efficient, it's going to be faster to produce. Improved medical facilities. We have medical care that can be able to detect, treat, prevent cancer, for example. We have a healthy population, we have a productive population. Good governance, good governance. By good governance, yeah, we are referring to where the government comes up with policies and laws that are going to promote innovation. Good natural resource environment. Country that has gas, country that has minerals, forests, wildlife, and so forth, is going to develop faster. Then we also talk of presence of strong entrepreneurial culture. When there is strong entrepreneurial culture, right? People have businesses, right? They inherit businesses. Then the economy is going to develop. Next, we look at economic underdevelopment. We talked about economic development. Now we are talking about underdevelopment. Now, this refers to a situation where there is a decline in the standard of living in our country. The standard of living is going down. Then we talk of economic underdevelopment. What are some of the characteristics of underdevelopment? One, what do you look at to tell this is a underdeveloped? One, increase in the level of poverty. So underdeveloped countries have lower capital incomes, which results in poverty that is reflected by a decline in the standard of living. When there is a lot of poverty, that's a good show that the country is underdeveloped. High dependency levels, so underdeveloped countries tend to depend to a large extent on developed countries' financial aid since they cannot sustain themselves financially. Right? Poor infrastructure. Infrastructure such as roads and communication networks are poorly developed in underdeveloped countries. And this is due to lack of adequate finances to improve infrastructure. Remember, if there's no infrastructure, then farms will not be transported. transporting the raw materials industry, and they'll be unable to transport the finished products to the market in China. Low labor productivity is another characteristic. So the level of output from production in underdeveloped countries is extremely low. This is a result of poor quality, elementary factors such as tools and management. Then we look at outdated cultural practices like